好，谢谢柳青瑶小姐姐，您先休息一下，一会儿我再来找你聊。
好，我们刚才可能直播的开始有一点的技术问题，但是希望大家也能听到了大部分的这个音乐。
那边是B站的UP主，我们的琵琶能手柳青瑶本尊啊。
我现在是在交河古城，它是世界上保存最完整的、最大的、最古老的这种生普城市建筑群。啊，我们今天会讲它的历史。再看一下这个夕阳，它落得真的非常快。刚刚看网友留言，就说这是新疆吗？还是大白天？
So
this is in Xinjiang for sure, although maybe in Beijing time is already the dark, total dark, but here you look at it still in a lifetime. My name is Xu Xingchen from CGTN, and right now you are tuning with CGTN New Media. We bring you this Jiaohe, an ancient city spanning over 2,000 years in Xinjiang. Of course, I'm not the master in this regard. I will invite two guests. They will introduce from A to Z about the whole stories here happened. And we have a wise curator, Madame Deng. And we also have a young man.
大家好，我是亚卡。这亚卡啊，就是
B 站现在其实，因为你有很多粉丝嘛，B 站上面可能就可以留弹幕啊，留问题啊。So madam, we'll start with you. We look at this Kash ruin, and we just visited before. If you're tuning in with CGTN New Media, amazing Xinjiang actually covered a whole span of all these projects. Here, Jiaohe actually is the abandoned at a quite early time. So we talk about this whole location is very important, right? Jiaohe or the Yak Hotel actually is a ruined city. It's very important a place. That's for the a northern group coming to the central places. That's also the a must go places. So once Jiaohe actually presented in the history, this is actually the place that should be domained by someone. That is why a lot of wars happened here for the ownership of this place. So look at all these soils. Actually, this is the without the processing. So we look at these actually. The city was built on a large islet in the middle of a river, which formed natural defenses, which would explain why the city actually lacked any sort of walls. Instead, you look at the steep cliffs, more than 30 meters high on all sides of the river, acted as natural walls. So this place is quite very special. I'm not, of course, a history person, but look at these ruins. But surprisingly, actually, we found trees. Look at the forest, actually, here. We have greens here. We talk about the Jiaohe. Actually, this means the two rivers actually combined here. So this is basically the a combination of two rivers. So we talk about the a whole Hanshu, that's the a history book, says the king of the a Zhushi lived in the town of Jiaohe, and the river divided into two and surrounds the town, which is why it is called Jiaohe or the a river junction. So that is why we talk about these places actually built up on the river, and also we look at the grains also surrounding here. And of course, once again, this was so important, and we talk about the a whole city actually built on that 30 meters high on all sides of the river. So that is also acted as natural walls. So they have the walls to as the a defending tools. So you know that is also very difficult to get inside the city. So of course, once again, this is a very important place, and also spanning over 2,000 years in Xinjiang. So we talk about the Jiaohe Ancient City on the western outskirts of Turpan. It's the largest, oldest, and the best preserved city. And also we need to mention about the Silk Road. And if you're familiar with the history in Xinjiang, we know that the west journey made by Zhang Qian. So basically, that person actually started the whole journey and opened up the ancient Silk Road. So along the Zhengjian's journey, actually, they found the a different ownership and also the a traps. And he had the a journey to the a Uzbekistan. And he found that person there actually not really aggressive. And also, by his journey, Zheng Qian found that there is a vast place called West Regions. And he also, for the very first time, he heard that there was a place called Egypt. So then, after Zheng Qian, more and more people actually traveled between the central plain region and the western regions. So they would like to bring Han Dynasty closely connected and linked with West regions. So we talk about the Xiongnu, that is the a tribe we have to mention. We talk about this is very important in terms of the a military perspective. So they had actually a 550 years long battle here. So we talk about the Wuzhengjushi, that is the five times actually had a war in the Jushi. So they really like to get the ownership of Xinjiang. And actually, since then, Xinjiang actually officially included in the territory of China. And also from then, a lot of ruins actually demonstrate that the effective jurisdiction of central government over the West regions. So we have to mention that is one thing called the Xiyu Duhufu or the a military officers' residence. So because that the Xinjiang officially included in the territory of China, so they established this residence representing that the a governor are assigned by the central government to charge of the a West region. So that's basically considered as the chief of the region, and also actually that is the a person actually managed 36 states. So basically before that 36 states actually they had their own ownership, and because of the Han Dynasty that have the a unified governors. So since then they established this residence, and from then that all these 36 states actually belong to the a jurisdiction of the a military governor's residence and also belong to the Han Dynasty. So we look at here, this is the Jiaohe ruins, and they also divided into different functions. Like they have the a places or the clusters of the a neighborhood, the a cluster of working places. So basically, you can consider that it is divided into the working places and the a living places. So this is also inspired by the architecture style from a Tang Dynasty. So we look at this, have the a Southern Buddhist Temple and also the a Central Avenue. So we talk about the a Central Avenue actually was the highest place. And you also look at that, you can find by judging the a style of the architecture, actually a lot of these styles were inspired by the a central plain areas. So there were more than 550 temples here. You can tell people actually believe in the Buddhism. So this place is a very important place, not only for the military meaning, but also for the a merchant trading perspective. So this is also the a gateway connecting the people from the western to the central area, from the north to the south, and this is also the heaven of a Buddhist. So before, this is just the desert, and also people change it to oasis, and also a lovely living paradise. So we mentioned a little bit the history and the background of Jiaohe. So we are here standing on the soil of Jiaohe ruins. So we really can literally touch the history. So back to the ancient time, Buddhism was quite prevailing in ancient time, especially in the West region. There were a lot of Buddhist activities going on. Though right now we only saw the soil, the ruins of temple, but actually you could restore in your mind
the
activities that just vividly in front of your eyes. So we talk about which is the most appealing part of Jiaohe ruins. We talk about it once again. We have to mention this time and again. Jiaohe Ancient City on the western outskirts of Turpan is the largest, oldest, and best preserved city of native architectures in the world. And also look at the styles of that architecture. Actually, we're inspired by Tang Dynasty. So this is a place actually in West regions, but you look at all these buildings, actually you can tell that's the style from the Tang Dynasty, from the central plain regions. Ancient Silk Road, there were a lot of stories we can talk about. So we have the prehistorical ancient Silk Road, but actually with the establishment of the military officers' residence that officially embarked the Silk Road residence. So that is in Chinese, Anxi Duhufu. So that is the place actually to governor a military perspective, social perspective, economic perspective, actually all belonged to the administration of that military official's residence. We not only saw the promising trade going on between the different among different traders, and we also look at that Buddhism,
Taoism,
and also the other beliefs actually
all going on and also spreading here.
So we talk about the Jiaohe not only from the historical perspective, there actually is the home established and created by the people from different nationalities. To look at the layout, the architecture, all demonstrate that the central jurisdiction and also the harmonious
results
of different nationalities. So this is the very first time for me to visit this place. So we actually, just for me, it's a totally different feeling when our viewers seeing all this landscape. But for me, I'm right now standing on the soils. You'll talk about this splendid or amazing architecture. Think about this. This is 2,000 years ago established on this landscape. You had this kind of architecture. How great were they? So if our viewers, you have time and opportunity, do please visit this place. It's really amazing place. So you could tell the wisdom and the diligence of hardworking people.
到了东汉时期呢，在
we talk about five times battle happened in 车师, that's the place called 车师. So once the Han dynasty actually took over the administration of 车师, then that also actually started to get the a jurisdiction of the old other states. So they started to establish the a different the a regions. And from the 450 AD until 640 AD, the Jiaohe places became Jiao Prefecture in the Tang Dynasty, and in 640 AD, it was made the seat of the a new Jiaohe County. And from the 640 AD until 648 AD, it was also the seat of the a Western regions governors, and also the a they had the a highest level military post of the a Chinese military commander post in the West, and we also had because this is very important in the a military perspective. So the a king or the emperor also sent his son as the a chief commander to overlook the whole places. So the city actually was very important. Although look at all these steep cliffs, the whole city actually built up upon that 30 meters high on all sides of the river, but actually you still could feel that the a vivid historical vitality. All these ruins actually convey the message of the activities going on here in ancient time. And we'll also talk about these places that actually also was reserved for Buddhist sites of temples and stupas. And also look at this actually road is really wide. This is not something actually we made in the modern time. These are actually already formed in the Tang Dynasty. So the whole city was finally abandoned after its destruction during an invasion by the Mongols in the 13th century. And also talk about the year, a lot of the fine traditions, and people should walk on the right side. Actually started from Tang Dynasty, we practice a lot of the fine traditions that carry forward even till today. So we talk about that. We should walk on the right-hand side or stand on the right-hand side. Actually, that already practiced here in Jiaohe 2,000 years ago. And also at each important junction, we also had the military personnel to take the guard. And also, the air curfew actually also practiced in the evening. So actually we talk about the home management or the administration actually was also very important and interesting. A lot of practice actually also can be applied even today. And please forgive us because this is the ruined places, so we cannot really go different places, but the drone help to provide these bird views. So we look at actually the places we are looking at, that's a cluster of the residents. So the place is divided by this central avenue. So these are the large residence clusters. This place actually, you look at the larger size of these buildings, these for the higher ranking officials, and the smaller houses or the architecture and was for the a normal public. So that it's the logic of the layout, and also in the central places, there was the a temple, and we also have around 50 temples gathered here.
这是一个平台，就是台地的平台是在上面，然后掏洞为室，隔梁为墙，形成了一个佛教寺院。其实它的这里的建筑也都是这样的特色。So
the temples.
那么在陆番，夏天温度40多度，在这个台地上，我们感到没有。We
talk about Turpan, you know, in the summer, it's extremely, extremely hot. This was around 40 degrees Celsius. So it is really hot. Temperature, how people stay here. So look at this, actually they built really high ceilings and that actually keep really good ventilation, and inside it was really cool. And they also actually divided into the two stories, the a part actually above the ground, and also have the a ground underground layers. So people, especially from the central plain places, actually also brought the a culture and also their the traditions to this place. And they also burnt coal to get the room warm. So you actually we still can find that the black mark on the wall that basically talk about the how ancient people warm themselves in the winter time.
唐朝安西都护府的所在地，唐朝毫无疑问，它是中国历史上最伟大的朝代之一。所以，So
Tang Dynasty, of course, was one of the greatest dynasty in China. So think about that once in 400 years ago in Tang Dynasty, how could people make their way from Tang Dynasty or the Central Plain area to the Western area, these Western region places? Actually, for me, I can tell you that. Maybe surprise you, but actually myself, when I was standing here on this earth, actually I could actually brace as the same as the ancient people. For me, actually, I really traveled back the time.
其实我们这有个次干道，就是主干道和次干道，我们得从次干道往上走才是做。
So we have a main avenue, and we also have the a secondary main road or the administration district. So that is the place for the military officials or the military governor's residence. So the main avenue actually
help
people go directly to the main temple. And we talk about here the a secondary main road actually guide us to the officials or the administrators.
那么我们这个次干道到达的这个地方呢，最高点就是官署区，
so once again, actually, based on the layout, it actually can tell based on the different functions. So we have the clusters of residents, the clusters of working places, and clusters for the official office, and also the places for the burial section. So actually they also have different road guides to different gates. So that's the gates to define the safety of the whole city, and a gate actually also closed in the evening because that curfew also practice. And once again, that we mentioned about right now is the China's Golden Week holiday. It's the national holiday, so a lot of people actually travel to Xinjiang to experience this amazing light. So it also actually really enlightening or informed journey for all of us because there are a lot of really new knowledge. For us. So we also kind of experience the beauty of the ancient Silk Road. Bear in mind, this place actually span over 2,000 years. And all these ruins actually created by people at least 1,200 years ago. And also the buildings or the architecture plus the secondary main roads also had their logic because the road plus that the architecture also helped to be the barriers for the military soldiers. So if the enemies try to invade the city, also the military soldiers had took all these walls as the cover to kill the enemy. So we talk about the different gates as well as the layout. Actually, people could feel so assured that it's a very safe place. And also in Tang Dynasty, the people actually expanded their living places, and from the one town that also divided into different the villages and different tribes. Based on the historical records, the early period of Tang Dynasty in Turpan, there were 37,000 people living here. Of course, it's not all living in this place, but actually the total population lived in Turpan. When we talk about Xinjiang, we talk about Jiaohe, of course, we need to mention the Silk Road.
So
to establish this kind of the ancient city, what role it played in order to boost unity of nationality? So we talk about Han and Xiong Nu actually happened five the very important battles. This also can demonstrate that the here Jiaohe, the first of all, location was so important because one of the ancient Silk Road routes actually pass through Jiaohe and reaching to the different countries in the west region. So this is a must go through place. So there were two routes. And the skirts of Taklamakan desert.
因为讲到就是讲到我们交和古城，讲到丝绸之路这种历史渊源啊，就我想了解一下，就是因为你很年轻，是什么时候对历史产生了兴趣的？
So we talk about Jiaohe Ruin, we talk about ancient Silk Road. For the young man, so why you were so interested or fascinated, I can tell. Why are you fascinated in the history of Jiaohe or the history? So my parents, actually, give me that information regarding the whole history, different ages and different history, and also the process of a history development. So basically, that is my starting point. I'm although a science person, but really interested in history. So for this young guy, actually in his early 20s, we're so glad to see that the young generation like him really love history and embrace the history. We talk about we should strengthen our confidence in culture. So first of all, you need to have a correct understanding of our history. We talk about the culture. We talk about the history. So we need to really let our public, let our society to know more and stay closer to our history. So look at this ruin that really help us to understand the history, to help us understand the background of the history, and also what happened back then, and also what kind of culture going on here, as well as the different nationalities. So there were a lot contained in that ruin. In 2014, the General Secretary Xi Jinping actually initiated that Belt and Road Initiative. We talk about we should be open up and inclusive. I believe that also add the eight new meanings to Xinjiang. I believe Xinjiang will also enter into a new era and also embracing new opportunities for further development.
So we talk about that
hope our joints can help you provide that the whole shape of the city, actually that the city's shape is quite like an aircraft carrier. So for the ancient people, actually, they built up this city on a large islet in the middle of a river. So although it built on the river, but actually was so dry, so drought. So the very early, we'll talk about the first generation of people living here, they should be really creative and intelligent. And they were great people that they could stay here. Also, generation after generation, they could be prosper in this place. And here we go, lady back again. Why are you carrying a watermelon? So actually, we have to mention this, and also watermelon and also fruits. So tasty in Xinjiang. So I believe in the ancient time, this very beautiful lady actually is quite familiar. And also it's how really ancient people dressed up.
Distinctive
offerings to the god, to the heaven. So watermelon, maybe back then, was one of the offerings. And your makeup, your costume were really beautiful. How long you spent from high to tall? 3 hours. So my hairstyles, the costumes and makeups actually took the lady 3 hours for preparation. So just now, a lady performed a pipa show called Brave Man. So we talk about back then in Jiaohe, we established the highest level military post of a Chinese military commander posted in the West, or that is the place we called the military governor's residence. 658 AD, so the residents moved to Jiuzi and also helped to expand the territory. So the first director actually
它的吐鲁番的主要作用就是分配土地，安定社会。
The a daughter in the a son-in-law of the a Baghdad Empire, so you could tell actually this place was very important, and also the a officials, the empire attached great importance to the governance of this place. So that is why he sent his son-in-law to Godmir administrate the place.
站在那个上面的时候，其实，就是心里还是有点颤颤巍巍的感觉，因为地上的每一寸土都感觉，被风吹过，然后被我踩过，然后就感觉很不一样。
也感受到了故人的气息。
尤其听着
这悠扬的乐曲，就感觉到
回
归到一两千年的汉唐时代了。能够想象出古代的人们也穿着这样的服饰，在这条路上行走，有孩童们在追逐嬉戏，可以说它是一个非常热闹的一个城市。
我要说就是我脑袋里面已经有画面了，这感觉真的是太好了。
So think about that ancient people actually dressing up like this, and also perform the pipa, or actually just walking on this road. So I can tell the whole picture is so vivid. So really, actually, I'm playing pipa.In the sunset, actually, it's really for me, it's like I really talked to the ancient people through the music. So we talk about the a garlic, sesame, the a beans,
nuts,
actually all these are introduced by Zhang Qian from the western regions to the central plain area.
一个葡萄藤，还是红果的原粒葡萄，
在吐鲁番，
在吐鲁番发现的亚含古木群
，also introduced，
所以吐鲁番是瓜果之乡。
Journey to the West。
打断一下，张骞算是你的偶像对吗？
算是。
Actually, that also happened.And found in Turpan. We talk about Turpan, the home to the great fruits.
就是你讲张骞的时候，你整个人都放光。真的，真的有啊，有这种感觉。
是。
So actually for me, I actually admired people that had their name really recorded in the history. So when we mention that great names in the history, I believe everyone is so touched and excited. So you were actually that Han custom? So think about a name when it comes to
the history.
So I would like to choose Li Bai. Because we can talk from his poem, he's really romantic and really creative. So we both actually, for that creative performance, he actually used his poem, I used pipa, we believe we had a lot in common.So we talk about the Cenzen that is also very famous, the a poet in the history, and actually he had a lot of the a poem actually recording or the representing the a whole look, especially the a picture rustic.History happened in Luntan. So basically from his poem, from his lines, we could tell back then the a whole weather, the a musical instruments that happened in the ancient history, especially in the a Turpan area, in Xingtai.So we also got to tell that the a weather condition, whether the place was dry or white. We also talk about that the a post, because we need to have several posts for the merchant traders to stay over, right? So the a post actually helped the a merchant people.
就类似是物价是它定期的去市面上流通的货物定价，然后我们在这个事故文书上呢就能够看到当时人们的日常用品是什么。特别有意思的就是在新疆，我们这个基本上算是中国最内陆的省份。在唐朝的时候，我们发现当时人的餐桌上他们能够吃到海带，对。
Guidance. So very importantly, actually, in Xinjiang, this is so the invoice place is actually back then on the table.
of the Xinjiang people, actually, they can taste
a
very surprising tool, and that's the kelp. So this is something quite
surprising.
So from this book, actually, we will talk about that the pricing of different items. And actually, that is also managed by different sectors. Based on the DA quality levels that also recorded in different levels. So I also talk about that not only that have DA best quality products, we also talk about the silk. Actually, once again, we talk about ancient silk road. This is the place not only for trading purpose, but also actually this place produces silk itself. So we talk about the DA silk products were so well known. So still we need to mention Zhang Qian's name, right? So because that person that opened up that Silk Road, actually Silk Road really helped that really trading different kind of food. Once again, we talk about the kelp. So that is something we only could find at the coastal cities. But at this inland place, actually so amazing that we found people back then that had kelp served on their table. So the nearest place actually from the Korea. So from the Silla of Korea, that was the nearest coastal city. Actually, we talk about the price is really amazing because that's really affordable. So more than 1,000 years ago, kelp were quite popular and welcomed by the people here in Xinjiang. And we also have the traders from Jiangsu, really far from here. But once again, we talk about from different the origin of food and also the places of the trader coming from. You could tell back then this ancient Silk Road was really busy and gathering a lot of people from different places. It's really promising places. So once again, Xinjiang here is still actually to have some daylight. But we need to mention that the big weather or temperature differences in the morning time and evening time.
我觉得是很重要的，也是一个让我启发我很多的一个嘉宾。他是使徒馆，是在B站的一个up，他是个B站的一个。
The young man is our special guest, and also he's a quite DA blogger, very famous DA blogger. And he has his channel as well. So actually, he's so insane in history. Basically, he had the DA channel to talk about the history, to talk about the DA Chinese history, the DA Chinese map, how that changing along with the time. So this is really great places. So Jiaohe Ancient City and the western outskirts of Turpan is the largest, oldest, and best preserved city of native architecture in the world. It's a witness of Xinjiang's uniqueness and a testament to the integration of cultures and people. So right now you are tuning with CGTN New Media. This is our special coverage of amazing Xinjiang. So actually, for CGTN New Media, we had this special product, DA program, for right now is already more than 20 days. So this come to our 27 or 28 days. So you can find this amazing Xinjiang on our social media platform to really introduce these kind of history stories, cultures, the local traditions to our viewers.
历史这么长，人们在这里怎么生活？那么交河在沟北，在它的台地后面那儿有一块很小的是墓葬区。So
we talk about this is a living places, right?
So we only talk about the residence part, the living part. Then we talk about when people died, where there was a place they buried. We had a place at the back of the whole territory, that it was the place for burying residents, and also based on archaeological finding. Also, actually, based on the pottery, as well as the golden wares we found from our excavation. That we also could tell that was the place to bury horses.
And
we also found a tomb. Actually, that the places buried the people from Central Asia. They also went to this place for trading.
These places were trading.
So the a group of people actually from the A5 and nearby states, they were really good at trading. So in Turpan, actually, they took this place as their residence, as their home, their second home. So they would like to stay here as their permanent residence. So they could establish their network of trading.
可以说这里的苏特人也和这里的土著居民呢共同的生活在这里，并且文化上也受到汉文化的影响，比如说它的墓志是用汉文写的，还有出土的一些丧葬习俗跟中原建筑是一致。
So we talk about this place, we look at the stellar of architecture and also the scriptures, the words.
有人问这个是遗址吗？对，这是遗址，叫焦和古坟，在吐鲁番伊西13公里左右。对，西郊的地方叫个焦和古坟，然后是对游客开放的。然后房子是土盖的吗？可以是。
So this is Jiaohe Ancient City, and the western place of a Turpan. It's around 30 kilometers to Turpan.
So
we talk about the place actually is not people built and building. Basically, they dig the whole building out.
就是刚刚其实我们航拍应该是有拍到，但是因为我们的直播信号的原因，这是个遗址，它的信号是间断性的，所以我们只走了一部分。但是我们刚才航拍应该是已经有拍到。
And also different people, the traders from different nationalities, also brought their culture, their tradition to this place. So our drawings actually help to provide a different angle of the picture of these places.
这个城虽然因为战火所废弃。 但是呢，居民都是生活在周边，慢慢的保存下来，延续下来。然后刚才有人在夸两位，就是其实邓馆长。So
we talk about the
descendant。我们的女嘉宾非常漂亮，然后这边是我们的。Actually,
people later on lived in the surrounding
places。然后这边是我们 B 站 UP 主，然后我们非常厉害的。 琵琶艺术人，我该怎么讲介绍你啊？都音乐人啊，柳青瑶，然后他的 B 站那个 ID 是柳青瑶。So
we have the really two young people joining our young guests joining our program, and also have my dad as the AY's curator of the local museum. So actually the two young guests, they were really talented. The lady actually really good at playing pipa. And that's also come to the end of our live streaming. And of course, I just hold tight my watermelon, and you are watching the live streaming brought you by CGT New Media. This is our special program called Amazing Xinjiang. We traveled a lot of the places. And later on, we'll also to the Urumqi and finish the whole journey at 10th. We are here at Jiaohe Ruins. It's already dark here. Thank you so much for tuning in our program. Thank you.